in order to test my CNC version 3.2.2, I've made another rover. The parts of the vehicle are cut from aluminum sheets of the dimensions 300×500mm with a thickness of 3mm. In a first run I was using a two-flutes cutting tool with a diameter of 1.5mm, a type of tool that I had used in previous test runs cutting plastics. The 3mm aluminum was cut in several runs with a depth of 0.5mm per step. To keep the noise level low, the speed of my spindle is set to approximately 8000 revolutions per minute, which is the lowest value possible. The result is a fine cutting line with a smooth surface. A disadvantage of the 1.5mm tool is that this type cracks quickly whenever the machine parameters are too far from optimum. Operating errors result in a noticeable loss of money over time. That's why I tried 3mm tools with 2 or 4 flutes next. I did a couple of tests using different feed rates, spindle speeds and depth per run. Caused by the low pitch of the 6mm threaded rods used for the linear drives, my CNC isn't a high speed machine, with the current setup I'm reaching no more than 4mm per second. The control unit of the CNC is a Simatic IoT 2020 and the Yocto Linux running on this PC has no real-time support. That's why there is a break in the movement of the axis every now and then. Not optimal, but because of the low machine speeds, it's acceptable in practice. With try and error, the results became better over time. Even the 3mm cutting tools are not indestructible. The water jet must hit the tool or else there is no cooling at the edge of the aluminum plate. Furthermore, the cutting tool has to be tightened correctly with the chunk or else it will stop rotating under side load. That operating error cost me tool number 2. Using the 1.5mm tool results in fine cutting lines. With the 3mm tool, twice the amount of aluminum has to be cut. Design the cutting lines in such a way that small bridges are left over, or else your tool will very likely get destroyed when the parts get loose at the end of the line. After the machining is done, you can remove the bridges and so get all parts out. Only with the correct machine parameters you get smooth cutting lines, this deck shows my first experiments. If the feed rate is too low or the spindle speed too high, the aluminum is grind to dust rather than being cut. Wrong machine parameters result in an unwanted burr on top of the aluminum plate, as well as in a very rough cutting edge. I got good results using the 3mm 4 flutes tool. With that I've cut the 3mm aluminum in a single run. The mechanics is sturdy enough to counterbalance the acting side loads. Cutting must result in clearly visible chips on top of the aluminum sheet. Fine aluminum dust means you are grinding rather than cutting with a too high spindle speed. Too large chips are an indication that the spindle speed is too low, resulting in too high side loads acting on the cutting tool. If the parameters are ok, you get really good results with this machine. I have weakened the aluminum with a 1.5mm deep cut along special lines. With that you get precise bending edges. After the parts for the tracks, I've cut the wheels of my rover. I was using a 2mm 2 flutes tool in order to get fine cutting lines. The aluminum plate was cut in 2 runs, 1.5mm each. The first parts I've cut are for the tracks of my rover. 2 different parts are needed for my design. Screw heads operate as hinges and I could also use the not so perfect parts of my experimentations to get a working chain. Same as with the chainlinks, the bending edges of the wheels are weakened by 1.5mm deep cuts. Here I'm cutting the chassis, once more using the 3mm 4 flutes tool. There is a grid of 240 3mm holes on the base plate of the chassis. Bending the parts results in three-dimensional structures. After assembling all parts I got a very sturdy tracked rover. The accuracy of all parts is really good, I only had to remove the sharp edges manually with a file. Especially at the chain links, the rounded edges prevent the tracks from blocking the drive motors. Those drive motors are standard hobby servos for continuous rotation. The central brain is once again a Simatic IoT 2020 with a mini PCI VLAN module for networking and an IP camera to transmit live pictures to a browser. For driving in darkness I've added 4 LEDs on top of the camera that can be tilted through a third servo. It's a really nice robot platform with space left for additional electronics. This rover is made to explore unknown territories on the floors of maker fairs I will visit in the future to demonstrate what my CNC version 3.2.2 is good for. In my Robospadium we can have fun in driving more robots through a browser interface, try it out. If you'd like to support me in the development of my CNC machines and in keeping my robots running, you can use the donate button on my pages, many thanks to all existing backers. Thanks for watching and I'll be back.